Now that we know how to display a dialog box on the screen and how to use variable to assign values, let's go to the next exercise. We'll try to pass data from one activity to another. Let's add an activity, an input dialog that will ask you to enter some text. Selecting an activity allows you to inspect its properties. This is located in the right side of your workflow. This is where we put important data in different fields of our activity. We can set the properties directly in the properties section, or we can double click on it. For example, this title is the name of the dialog box. Let's name it question box. And the label will be what's your name? This one displays a text inside the dialog box. And the output, it's a variable, and the variable name is automatically generated. This one saves whatever the user has entered in the input box. Always remember that many of the activities in our workflow requires both an input and an output. So in this case of our input box, the output will be the text entered by the user. Let's say you forgot to declare a variable in your workflow and you put a variable name directly by not putting quotations to it. UiPath will consider it as a variable or a special keyword used by UiPath. UiPath will give you this little red exclamation icon that will give you information about the error. To fix it, we always create a variable in the variables section of our workflow before using it. Let's give it a proper name by going here in the variable section. Let's change this to name. I'm sure you're excited to see the result. Let's make this as a start node. And let's give it a go real quick. Now, let's say we want to capture the user input and return it in our message box. Let's add a message box in our workflow. Let's add the text value into our message box. This time, we will be using name, which will call the value of our input box. To make it simple, whatever user has entered, it will be displayed on the message box. Let's run it to see the results. Awesome! Now, you can see the passing of data from one activity to another using variables. What if I wanted to add some text in the message box aside from the text entered by the user? Okay, now it's getting exciting. Let's add another variable. Let's call it message. We'll be using this one for our message box. And the text that will be displayed will be the data of the variable message. There's a special activity we can use. We can use A plus B assign activity to concatenate the value of a variable and add string to it. The assign activity has a left part, a variable, and a right part, which is an expression. Whatever the value of the expression on the right, it stores it in a variable on the left. So, we put the variable of the message box here, in the left side. And on the right side, we'll put our expression, hello, plus name. The plus operator will concatenate the word hello and the text entered by the user, which is stored in the variable called name. Remember, we didn't put quotation on a variable. Well, let's review what we have done so far. First, our input box have a variable named name, which will store the data entered by the user. Second, the A plus B assign activity gives another value to our message box by adding the word hello to it. Lastly, our message box will display the output of the variable named message. Alright, are you ready? Let's run it. Perfect! In the next video, let's learn about conditions. Thanks for watching!